Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hit. But. Yeah. Ha. A bit of fiction. They don't want any beets, but he's smoking cigarettes. Hit. Tell him this kid. Gonna wash my hands. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today we will be cooking beets. I will be showing you how to cook beets. I am just relaxing today, so I'm just going to show you the procedure of how to do the beets. These are dirty, make sure you wash them off, but we're gonna cut them, prep them. I am going to submerge them almost like we confit the chicken. I'm going to confit the beets. It had the leaves on, but I cut them off. Cleaning them up whole, then we'll wash them off and get them in the oven. Careful what you use because it will stain the bowl. This is red, it will stain the bowl.
My life.
Going to wash these off, guys. This cutting board off, it looks like a first 48 scene. Look at this, y'all, when you look at all that dirt. Mm-hmm. Energy. All right, y'all. So I rinsed them off. They have this vibrant. What is this? Red, purple, burgundy. I don't know. Y'all figure it out. Yeah. See, it's still a little bit of residual dirt on there. But other than that, it's all cleaned up. Your water should be fairly clean. Okay. I just drained the water. Come back over. Be back with the second portion. Welcome back to the second portion of how to make beets. I will be confiting these beets just like we confit the chicken. It requires oil, so please don't get scared away from doing the procedure. But please do be careful, because this aluminum pan will get excruciating hot and very heavy. So I actually have just already cracked the oven, so I can place them right in the oven. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 medium to small to large size beets. Small being small, medium being medium to large. They're vibrant. They didn't look all dusty like the thumbnail that had dirt all over it. And we are going to completely cover these to confit them. After we take them out of the oven, they will be soft and tender. You're also going to need a towel to rub the skin off at the end. I will show you that procedure later. We're going to get them in the oven now, and we'll be back. I will also conclude the time and the temperature at a later date. Right now, I'm just going to add the oil and get them in the oven. This is a quick addition, so excuse the music if you like it, and if you, well, excuse the music if you don't like it, and if you do, then I hope you are enjoying. Is not that long, so I will conclude with the volume down lower, everything that I did, just in case you can't hear or if the music is too loud. So that's why I'm elevating my voice. As you can see, I used a whole bottle of canola oil, which is used oil, which is good to incorporate the flavor. This is 1 quart. I had another quart as well. That definitely was a quart. So you can still see that the pan is about halfway. It's not filled up yet. So I'm going to add another quart of oil, or however much fills it up. If it gets filled, that's when you can stop. But we need this to be filled all the way up, or the procedure will not happen. This is the procedure. And you can see. Let me see. It's okay to use different oils. I just used another quart of vegetable oil. Like I said, this is all fat and oil. That's all the method of confit is. It's oil, fat. So I'm gonna add a little bit more, and this is a different oil as well. I wouldn't use any type of peanut oil or anything like that because the smoke point is pretty high and you don't wanna burn your oil. I can reuse all of this oil, so it doesn't matter if the quantity that I'm using, because I can use this later. Okay, so yes, you see how much oil that was? It is a lot, as you can still see. Make sure you have a heavy pan and a pan that's deep enough to hold all this oil and hold exactly with the weight and what you're cooking, which is a beet, and that's pretty heavy. So this is not completely submerged. It's not going to kill anything. It'll just probably be a little bit of tedious, just every now and then kind of just turn it. And if you're not turning it, definitely make sure, you have to turn it. Make sure you rotate it, make sure you turn it to get that even cook time all the way around. If not, you'll have portions of beets that are tender and portions that are feel more coarse and more harder to chew. And you don't want that. You want a perfect tender beet that could be cut, placed on a salad or whatever. So they almost look like balls. You can see the height of what's sticking out of the oil. So that's the portion that you're gonna have to turn completely around and rotate. I'm starting the oil out in the oven on 350, and then I wanna lower it down to 300. For something like this, I would probably keep it at 350 just so the residual heat can cook around the circumference of the beet without me having to do too much, because usually I can just put this in here, leave it alone, and allow it to cook. Now I have to rotate it because I didn't have put enough oil in there, which is okay, but I'm just telling you the procedure so you'll know. This is very, very heavy. Be careful. I'm going to put it in the oven, and I'm going to allow you all to watch a little bit of the method, because these beets will go for a long time, and I'm not gonna showcase everything through the oven because that is very, very just long to watch sometimes. But other things when they're baking, I like to showcase through the oven. So I know I've been doing it a lot. We'll be doing things a little bit different today as far as the loud music, to where hopefully it's not drowning out my voice, but if it is, it doesn't matter. I'll recap everything a little bit later, just to ensure you're aware of the full procedure. Okay, so we're going into the oven. Give me 1 second while I reposition the camera. We are now in the oven. You just want to make sure that your oven is set at 300. Start low and slow. I actually started at 350. And I went for about 30 minutes on 350, and then I dropped my temperature to about 300. After your oven is on 300, it is just important to make sure that you are paying attention to your products. I have a skewer that I will be using later on in the video to test the product to make sure of the tenderness You'll see the entry of the skewer is short at first, meaning that it didn't insert all the way. That means it needs more time. And then you can see at the end where the skewer is pretty much discolored with the red. Discolored with the red from the product of the beets. And you can see that it goes from short to being elongated. And then that just tells you that pretty much the skewer went through, all the way through the beet, and it is ready to eat. So just pretty much test it out like potatoes. Just make sure you test it out like potatoes when you're doing potato salad or something like that, and you're testing your potatoes to make sure that they're soft. And of course, you don't want mushy anything, so you don't want your beets to go too long. As well as your potatoes, you don't want those to go too long too, because if you're making something like potato salad, then it's not going to hold its form. But for something like mashed potatoes, that'll be fine, because you're going to be pureeing it or smoothing those out. So it's just different concepts when it comes to roots, because potatoes are a root, rutabagas are a root, and beets are a root. I also included in the video later when I was seasoning it that beets do require a little bit more salt than something regular, like something delicate like fish. It's a root, so it's thick, it's hardy, it requires a little bit more salt than normal. I really like to use celery salt and garlic salt. Those salts incorporate powders in them, being celery powder with celery salt and garlic powder with garlic salt. So it's not straight salt, and it's also celery salt is actually natural, has that natural derivative. It's not just salt where you're getting straight salt and chemical salt, a portion of chemicals, but you should be getting the good stuff. Hey guys, so I have just been, like I told you all, rotating it. I just did it. You can see some dark spots and stuff like that. That's not abnormal. As you can see, it looks, you can see the red coloring and stuff like that coming out. Beautiful color. And it has this beautiful, earthy, nutty, and meat flavor to it. And the bacon and meat flavor is coming from the oil being used, and the earthy and nutty flavor is coming from the beets. It smells so good. I used to always love when we cooked off beets in house. Welcome back. The beets have been in here for a little over an hour. You'll start to see the skin wrinkle. There's a good spot. You'll begin to see the skin wrinkle, or almost like the beets are tightening up, which they are. This is a portion in a concept and what happens during roasting or baking procedures. The product tenses up because you're drawing out those liquids when you roast and when you bake. Okay, so that's why we don't leave things in the oven for a long time. If you notice during the barbecue, if they are left in the oven for too long, you will notice everybody talking about your stuff being dry, or you will have to add more sauce on it
more butter, whatever the dressing is. So we've all done, had to do it before. So as you can look here, there's some magic happening. The skin is bubbling. Okay, the oil underneath is bubbling. You also see that red residue from the beets, that beautiful color. You can also do all type of tricks with this stuff, guys. Save the you can use the juice to naturally bleed and discolor, you know, as natural food coloring for certain whatever, you know. Use your mind. The possibilities are endless when it comes to cooking and making different things. But I just wanted to show you how the skin is beginning to wrinkle and tighten up. This is where we'll have a dry rag at the end of the procedure, after the beets cool, after you have been very, very careful, remove this heavy pan with all of this hot above 350 degree oil. Please be very, very careful when you're confiting. This is the method that we're using. We are confiting beets, okay? So it's a little tongue twister, especially for someone like me with a lisp, okay? So we will be back. I will have a dry towel or a dry rag, something clean, sanitary, where we can take the skin off after the beets have dried and, well, not dry, but we're just going to allow them to sit, get some of this oil off, and then you don't want to wait too long. They might be hot. Use double gloves. If you don't want to use double gloves, like I said, allow them to cool, but once it cools, the skin is a little bit harder to come off. I like to get them off while the beet is still soft on the inside. It still has that hard exterior almost. However, you'll be able to get that skin off very quickly. And then you can allow them to rest, cooling all the way down to room temperature or even very cold if you are using them to prep for beets to go on a salad or whatever the end result is, pasta, salad, whatever. People use beets or incorporate them into many dishes, savory, sweet, and also cold or hot, okay? See you back in a minute. Welcome back. Wow, what are we in, the hour and a half to 2 hour mark? Look at this, baby. This is what we want. This is confit, okay? This is gorgeous. Cooking from the outside in is what the oil is doing. It's breaking down everything on the inside. A little tester, as you can just touch the top too to see if they're getting tender. And they are still really, really, really firm. But you know, like I said, you want them to still be, they'll still be pretty firm. But you'll be able to tell the tenderness. We can do a little test. I have a big toothpick here, long grill toothpick or a skewer, and you can just kind of, just like a potato, you see that, how it moved all the way back and how it was resisting. It literally pushed back like a hockey puck. That one did too. Even if I stick it straight in, see that, it stuck in a little bit but not all the way through, so it's got definitely some more time to go. Y'all think this is a long procedure? It is, but baby, when these things set on up, that thing gonna be good. Okay, nice and tender, earthy beets. Oh my God, they'd be so good. And I usually put mace on them. There's a seasoning called mace. It's almost in the, cinnamon or nutmeg family. Don't quote me, but check it out, M-A-C-E, mace. And it gives you like an earthy, sweet, and savory flavor. It's so good on beets. Beets, salt and pepper, and a little bit of mace, you'll be in the game. Thank you.
This is what we're looking for, guys. This is the Beets cooling, and they are dried up. They look drawed up. That is the skin ready to peel. I now threw some Ocean Perch in the oven really quick while my Beets are cooling down in preparation to prepare a meal. I literally got hungry during making, literally multitasking, making my clients' endeavors with this sweet potato cheesecake. So I wanted to make sure that those things were ready to go. And I just wanted to make a quick meal. So I threw some Ocean Perch in the oven. Right now I'm using a cheesecloth to take the skin off of those Beets. They have sat, but they were still pretty warm. I told you that I like to not wait till they cool all the way down, but you still peel that while it's warm. That way they come off easy. You can literally see that the skin is coming off very easy, and you can see the peel here, and it's just the outer skin of the Beets that are coming off. You'll see a little hardened areas where pretty much the outer skin of the Beets got roasted. That's fine, they will come off later by hand. Sometimes they flake off, or either you can use a knife and cut them off as well, which you will see me doing momentarily. I'm going to clean individually the Beets prior to cutting them up. Right now I'm still using this cheesecloth. Like I said, you can use a cheesecloth. It has that texture to where it grips things with those lines and those grids and stuff like that. You can use a towel, you can use a sanitary clean cloth that thereafter is going to go into the trash. As you can see, this cheesecloth is being stained by the Beets. Like I said, there's so many different things, innovative things that you can do with things like Beets and other things that bleed out so strong like this. As you can see, that's the outer skin. You can see all the soft and smooth spots, and then you can see, like I said, the hardened spots that are natural, and you can clean those up later. Like I said, it will stain your fingers, your hands, whatever the bowl that you're using. So try to use darker colors instead of lighter colors, because this is just a natural product that comes from the ground that is just very, very messy. And yeah, it's as you can see, we went 2 to 3 hours, literally almost. Definitely surpassed 2 hours on 300 degrees with the Beets taking its time becoming tender. So like I said, just use your judgment. I started off at 350 for 30 minutes, and then I went into 300 for about 1.5 to 2 hours thereafter. So yes, they do take some time. However, they're very, very healthy for you. Please don't get scared. I have to tell a quick story. When I was in culinary school, I consumed Beets. I didn't know what was going on, and like, I went to go urinate and I peed red. I was so scared. I didn't know what was going on. I don't know why I had the inclination to run to my chef, but I did. I ran to my chef. I don't know why I kind of put two and two together, but I'm like, chef, my pee was red. What's going on? I didn't know what was going on. I got scared or whatever like that. But he's just like, yes, the Beets will make your urine change colors. So that's actually a plus and an attribute of Beets. They cleanse your liver, they cleanse your urinary tract, and they are very, very good. Look them up and see what other essentials and features that they have. So as you can see, the skin is coming off very, very easy. And you can see the smooth outer skin. You can definitely tell the difference from the ones that are already cleaned on the left-hand side from the ones that are being cleaned on the right-hand side. And of course, we have our waste bucket on the left-hand side that I'm using. The double, I have a bowl and I have a strainer. I just wanted to strain those Beets just for whatever oil, the rest of the oil that fell off. That way it's not all over the counters or creating a mess. I'm continuing to clean the beets, and then I'm going to prep them by cutting them in cubes, and then I am going to saute them and incorporate some more seasonings. And not some more seasonings, I will be seasoning them for the first time, because I literally put them in the oven with no seasonings. You don't want those seasonings to burn. You're just literally doing a procedure. So as you can tell, this does take a very, very long time if you're not multitasking, if you're not doing other things to take your mind off of it. Because literally, it seems like it was quick for me, but it literally was a 2 to 3 hour process. And beets are very good for salads. They're incorporated in all type of different pasta salads, whatever you want. And I am using this these beets actually just for an aside to go along with my ocean perch. But this is just one of the complicated procedures for just a root vegetable. So I just wanted to feature this on my channel. Feel free, of course, to subscribe, ask questions, chime in, be interactive. I love questions, okay? So let's continue to watch as this cheesecloth is full of residue from the beets and almost looks like a crime scene. But that is the beauty of it. This is a beautiful, beautiful color right here, and a texture of the beets, and inside what it actually looks like. You can see those grids, almost like it looks like a fingerprint, but they're very, very gorgeous. The color is very, very pretty. And as I get into my groove, I'm just slicing, cleaning up the ends of the beets and also anything around the beets that's not edible. Like I said, those harder, firmer pieces can be cut off. And then like I said, I'm going to be going into my groove of things and cutting them in cubes. Just burn out. Don't wanna. Beets are a root, so it requires a little bit more salt than other things. So, it's a perfect, nice flavor though.
Smoking on Keisha.